ladies and gents, this is Linda, Fachic777, and today I'm coming at you with a design team project for the Piece by Piece. Now, this particular project, I am very sorry to say, will be my last design team project for the Piece by Piece for a while. I just need a little bit of a rest. I've got some issues with my lower back. I've had a few surgeries and this and that without, you know, going into a lot of detail. And, you know, I am on a lot of design teams and trying to do all that. I wasn't able to give myself a rest when I needed to because I felt like I just needed to keep going. So, and Bev is going to be adding some, you know, fabulous designers locally in her area for her brick and mortar stores. So, you know, this was a chance for me to just step back for a little bit. You know, we've talked and I'm hoping to come back in a while, but for right now, temporarily, I just need a little bit of a rest. Anyway, so personal things aside, let's get down to some creative business. Now, what I created was a Shabby Chic pincushion. Little story for you. About a year ago, a wonderful lady here on YouTube, Annie. Hey, Annie, Miss Garden Grove One. She designed this beautiful, just Shabby Chic kind of vintage pincushion on this cute little fabric chair. And she had some of these chairs that she was selling, so I quickly bought two of them. But, you know, it's a year later and I'm just finally getting around to doing this project. I just quite didn't know what I wanted to do with it, although I did know I wanted to create a pincushion kind of, you know, like Annie had done with hers. So I'm going to get my sign out of the way, and the first thing I'm going to do is show you how I kind of started out. You know, how the inspiration finally hit me and like, that's what I'm going to do to my pincushion / Shabby Chic chair, vice versa, the other way around, whatever you want to say. Okay, so I'm going to bring in my iPad. I was looking around on Pinterest and all I did was just Google Shabby Chic and, you know, all these different things came up, not particularly crafts, but maybe design concepts and things like that. So this is what I saw. Okay, it's a real chair decorated all Shabby Chic, and what I did was pretty much took it theme for theme. So the flowers here you're going to see on mine are going to be real flowers or paper flowers, you know, in the area of like Wild Orchid Crafts. This cute little pillow I just loved. I love the color of it because, you know, it looks all burlap with the word. Well, what I did is used a wood embellishment from my stash. It was that color and it had a word on it. This cute little, I wished I had one of these miniature, this cute little jar. I used a flower pot, a little mini clay flower pot in, you know, the place of that. I did do this kind of design. I had this awesome tattered, actually torn doily, this long like table runner type doily that I got at a garage sale for like 50 cents because it was so tattered and worn, but it was perfect because I didn't care that if, you know, I tore it up, and I actually tore it for what I used. And for this part here, I used cheesecloth. And then down here, I used just some gorgeous trims from the Piece by Piece and from my stash. So I took all these elements and put it into mine. So this is what got me going for my Shabby Chic chair / pincushion. All right, so enough of that boring stuff. Let's bring this in. Okay, now this chair is about 6 inches tall, I think 6 inches wide, and a little over 3 inches in depth. So here it comes in, and this is my cute little Shabby Chic chair. I know, I love it. Okay, as you can see, just point it out. I'm going to kind of turn it to the side just a little bit. See, so you can see here I've got like the cute little throws over the side of the chair like in the picture. I've got the cute trims all down here at the bottom. This right here is kind of my pillow idea, although it's not a pillow. It's basically just a color in the word. And then in here is my little cute jar, the flower pot that I used, the jar on the other chair, and then all my flowers going around. Okay, so I'm going to bring this in a little closer, and we'll just kind of take a slower... I've got to develop something more. I'm always sticking to the bottom. Develop a little closer look here. I'll kind of tip it forward and let you see. I didn't do anything to the chair. I wanted to leave it plain. I didn't like exactly cover the whole thing. Okay. I'm going to turn it to the side so you can see. And I was going to wrap my little trims on the bottom of these trims all the way around the back. But one of my trims, I think it was the one from the Piece by Piece, I didn't have enough. So I had to stop my trims at the side. So the back is just plain. Okay. Bring it around to the other side. And here's where you can get a look at the fabulous trims. All right, so let's just start with that. First thing, on the bottom, it's got these cute little feet. I didn't change them at all, but I did do a little bit of texture on them, kind of down at the bottom with my acrylic paint mixed with sand. So I did that, and then of course I used that mixture to texture all the flowers and everything. But this is a wonderful, beautiful French lace from Beverly's store. Beautiful, like a beige color, of course, as you can see. I don't know that she has this color still in stock, but I know she has this design of lace. And then this is just a trim from my stash. This is actually like a trim that was like many layers, so I cut this little strip off and wrapped it around. And then this is also another trim from my stash, and it had little hearts hanging from it, and so I cut, or not cut, because they're like little, I'll show you one of them because I used it on here. They're on little jump rings on this, so I took the little hearts off and saved them, of course, for later use, and then used one on here. So those are the laces around the bottom. Okay. So let's kind of start at the top. So right up in here, this is just a little applique from my stash that I kind of stuck in the center. And then this is half, I cut it in half, a little chipboard clock that I got from Saw's shop. This is a little Martha Stewart, I believe, little applique butterfly here, and I had just added some, see if I can bring it in and show you, there you are, you can kind of see it, just some little diamond gems, some little bling there in the center. Okay, this right here, and I've got the same again right down in here. Those are just little Prima resin, the little corner window pieces I stuck in there. All right. This is a little Prima resin bird cage. I've got it going on in there. And then I've got like a ton of flowers from Wild Orchid Crafts, or all the flowers. I've got like pink and white variegated flowers. I've got just like cream color. I've got like a dark pink going on in there. Here in the corner, this is, which, you know, everything gets covered up, but this is a beautiful wheat spray from Beverly's shop. It's like a variegated pink. Let me bring it over here so you can see a little bit closer. It goes from dark to light to a white in there, okay? There we go. Get a little closer so you can see it. I don't know if my lighting's very good, but anyway, you get the gist, right? And then amidst the flowers and stuff back in here, right in here and right in here, I've got those new Prima metal gears that have the hearts on them, the white color. And then a bunch of more Wild Orchid Craft flowers going on in here. Right here, this is a little miniature, I got it at a garage sale, a little miniature watering can. I just thought it was so cute. And all I did was just paint it up with the off-white paint, and then I added just a little bit of texture with the acrylic paint and sand. And what I wanted it to do is I placed it on the arm of the chair and kind of leaning a bit so it looked like it was watering the flowers, okay? And then also that came with that was these cute little garden tools. Let me bring it up a little bit closer, get the light in a little bit better. This little spade and then this cute little pitchfork looking thing. I'm not a gardener. So I stuck that inside this cute little clay, miniature clay flower pot going on there. Okay, and then on the side of the flower pot, I've got this cute little miniature daisy pink flower trim here, and that is from Beverly's store as well. Inside the flower pot, I just stuck some stuffing down in the bottom, and on top, I stuck this cute little pink rosette from Beverly's shop. And then, you know, and in the top of that is where I stuck these little miniature garden tools. And then right in the center, this is my little pin cushion on my chair. And all I did is I just stuck in some of these cute little pins that Jayzella had made me. Hey, sweetie! You know, just so this chair has a little bit of function to it, right? I mean, it can look pretty, but why not give it a little bit of function? So this is my little pin cushion. Okay, in front of that, this is a little clock. I believe it's a Prima clock. Forgive me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's where that came from. And then I've got a bunch more Wild Work of Craft flowers, some rose buds and things like that. Here's a little spring going on right there. In front of the flowers, kind of laying on the chair seat, is this cute rusty shovel. I got like a big bag of these at a garage sale. I've given a lot of them away, given quite a few to Miranda actually, and you know, just kept a few in case I ever used one. And I think this is the second one I've used. I used one on a Halloween project, but I just thought it was cute because this is kind of like a garden theme, obviously. And you know, we dig holes to plant things, right? Maybe not real big holes, that's what we would use this for, but what the heck, there it is, a cute little rusty shovel. And then here's a little wooden word, says charming on it. And then I used a little Prima, one of the little flat, I don't even know what this is called. It's from, you know, the new metals collection. It's got the little tiny gears and the little flat tops and everything that look like little screw tops and stuff like that, just to cover the hole in there. And then on the laying in the chair, let me go back because I've kind of sort of showed it to you. This, I'll show you up close, is the little tattered doily that I found at a garage sale, and I just ripped it up, as you can see, but it kind of looks like a throw hanging off of the side. And then I used some cheesecloth and kind of, you know, made the ends all distressed like it was another little throw hanging off the side of the chair, and then it goes down onto the seat cushion itself. Okay, so there's that side. And then on the front, on this arm here, I've got just these cute little circular sprays that have the little beads on them. And on the front of that, I've got this beautiful silk trim from Beverly's shop. Now, this is called the mauve color, but it looks, you know, like a vintage pink to me. It's not necessarily mauve because you can see it goes well with all the other pinks and light pinks and stuff that I'm working with on this project here. So I just kind of glued it to the front there. And then what I did is just kind of pleated it along the back. Used my hot glue gun and pleated it over, you know, the other pretty little trim I've got down here. And then I did the same thing along the front. I pleated it. I took it underneath that little tattered doily there, and then underneath to the underside of the chair, and just kind of tacked it down under there with some hot glue. Okay? And then from that, I have got hanging from the center of it a little heart. It's kind of like a resin heart. That's the little hearts. They're actually red that was hanging from that trim that I showed you at first. And so all I do is kind of gesso over it and then put the little sand texture over the top of that to tone it down, you know, so it's not red. The red kind of turned to a little light pink, obviously. If you add white over it, it can kind of turn a little pink. And then from behind that, I've got just a little metal key from my stash hanging there. Okay. And then over here, from a craft store that I go to a lot, but I am sad to say is now closing. It's about an hour away from me. It's got the coolest, just kind of eclectic craft items. It's got scrapbook stuff, but a lot of eclectic craft items and things you can alter and stuff. And it had this whole section with all these miniature garden things so that you could build like your own little miniature, like, topiary garden type thing in one of those big glass bowls or something. Anyway, one of the packages I picked up had this cute little metal wrought iron, you know, like wheelbarrow in it, and it had this cute little bird cage in it. And I bought a couple packages of those. I just love it. And what I did is just kind of glued it to the front of the chair sitting there. Because, you know, when we're messing with our shabby chic garden, we're often, you know, wheelbarrowing stuff around the garden. Or those of you that are gardeners. Anyway, and then inside the wheelbarrow, I stuck a bunch of little goodies in there, lots of a bunch more flowers. I have this little acrylic kind of see-through heart that I got at Dollar Tree. I stuck my infamous X and O on there. These are teeny tiny little Scrabble tiles I picked up at a garage sale. You know, the little travel Scrabble game. It had the little tiny ones in there, so I put those in there. Also inside, I kind of wound it through. It's behind this heart and winding through the flowers. You can see right here the little cute pink little daisy trim like I used on the flower pot from Beverly's store. And then I got the cute little teeny tiny pink candy gems that I just love, also from Beverly's store. And then this, they're not in stock right now, but of course, as we know, she carries tons of resin pieces. But this cute little teeny tiny owl, I know, I love it, it's so cute, is from Beverly's shop. It's a little vintage pink one. When she first came out with them, she sent some in her kit, and then I went back and bought like a few more, you know, like six or so more of them, because they're so tiny and cute. And I thought it would be cute just kind of sticking out of the wheelbarrow. So, cute little vintage pink resin owl. Love it! And then on the handles of the little wheelbarrow, this is just one of those recollections paper clips with the little, you know, pink flower on the front. I just thought it was cute. It really went in with the shabby chic theme. Okay? So, there it is. Here is my Shabby Chic / Pincushion Design Team Project for the Piece by Piece. I just totally love this. I think it's cute. I hope it gives you guys some inspiration to kind of, you know, create your own little Shabby Chic pincushion. I enjoyed making it. It's going to be super cute in amongst my supply of crafts. I, yes, am going to keep this one, which you all know, and I've said 1,000 times before, I don't often keep my stuff, but I just got to keep this one. But I believe I said at the beginning of the video, I bought a couple of these chairs. So I have one left to make for whomever I wish, whenever I want. You never know who's going to get one of these. Anyway, thanks for sharing your time with me. Leave a comment below. I just love reading them. I know I don't get back to everybody all the time. I do, however, try to go in and answer all your questions if you've got questions, but I don't always respond to every one of you just making comments. But know that I love you. I love your comments. I appreciate each and every one of them. As usual, I will have all the links below to everything, the Piece by Piece, and a link to my blog for close-up pictures and direct links to the products I used. Thanks for sharing your time with me, and I'll talk with you again soon. Bye.